Bonus Actual, this is Peyton. I'm getting the relay patched up, but listen, I don't know how else to say this, but I think we might have a saboteur on the base.
Saboteur? What makes you say that?
I caught a glimpse of an unidentified person as I arrived. Ran off a cliff before I could get a good look, but I think they were tampering with a relay tower.
Jim, no offense. You're not supposed to go stir-crazy until you've been here at least a year.
I'm serious, boss. Somebody was out here.
All right, Jim, I believe you. First things first. Head into the relay station, raise the satellite dish, and call up the tram. You'll need your rig for the next...
Okay.
broken. Okay, let's get this backup transferred.
Files transferring. Processing. Complete. Warning. Cardinal class storm approaching. This facility is an emergency lockdown.
play?
Who are you? Where am I?
I am Mira. You are in no danger here. Do not be afraid.
I'm still on EDN-3. Let's agree to disagree.
Rest. Your treatments have taken well, but your wounds were grave.
My wounds? Yes, I fell. Hard. I should be dead. You were there. Wait, I've seen you before. At the satellite relay and the abandoned base. You led me there.
You deserve to know the truth about this world.
How long have I been here?
12 or 13 days.
What?
We use the planet's nectar. My father's science.
Sister, I've rehabbed injuries before. Should have been down for months. So, all respect to your daddy's nectar, but one of us is a crazy woman here.
Here.
Wait, where's my rig?
I will take you to it, I promise. For now, rest.
Look, Princess, unless you're planning to break my legs again, I need to check in. And you're gone. That's great.
We'll be right back.
unusual behavior for that species. They're normally only aggressive when attacked.
Come, Jim. My father awaits.
A man of honor and a Nivik uniform. A true paradox.
You hate them like you know them well. You were Nivik too once.
Long ago, I was. We came here from Earth as you did. Come to tame the wilds, rendering fire from ice. We were unprepared.
Look, Chief, I don't claim to know what you've been through, but I know the odds you're up against. You're not wrong that we're here for a reason, but it's not to bring you harm, I swear. Let me help. Let me talk to my boss, Braddock.
Silence! Hand extends. They beckon. Come in from the cold. Long have we waited. When they fled to ships and flew away, I was certain they would return. If it could just last a week, surely they would come back for us. Persevere for a month. No doubt our rescue would follow. If only we could survive a year, or five, or 10, or 36! For 2 generations, we survived without their compassion. Invisible, cheating death. And finally, you would lead them to our door. Assurances of safety. Trust a scorpion. A man such as you had better know the nature of the beast.
here, Doc. I'm in position. And looks like I'm right on time.
Fire your winch at the tower and give it some time to collect the data. Your rig's going to act like a grounded relay for lightning. Don't worry. You should be safe.
Let's see what that did. Actual. You copy? The king is dead.
That a boy, Jim. We are well rid of that particular menace. Somehow I knew you would be the one to collect that bounty. I'll let Braddock know.
Yeah, LaRoche. You got beat by that? It wasn't so tough.
Is it an award you want? C'est toi le roi, hein?
Still after us. I should have known they'd never quit.
Stop. Stop. Don't worry about them. Just keep on talking, all right? You started the story. You better finish it.
Yes. Yes, all right. Where was I?
You nearly told Braddock about the survivors.
Yes. I nearly did.
I knew it wasn't my secret to share. Though I believed I had seen Braddock's heart that day. That for all his compromises and collaborations, he would never let any harm come to the survivors of the First Colony. I had started to think of the First Colony survivors as my people, just as I did the Coronis crew. I'd left one family on Earth just to find two more here. I was trying to be loyal to everyone that deserved it. Keeping secrets within secrets. To
deep down, I knew the situation couldn't stand. It was time to put my cards on the table. To get Soichi and Braddock together. In hopes they could forget the past. And finally heal by helping one another. I didn't know it was already in motion. I didn't know it was already too late.
Ah, damn, this thing looks like a charm.
Prepare yourself.
fed up. This is worn out, Lauer. In the name of Nevek, you are hereby ordered to stand down.
And return to base in my custody.
Roche, you don't need to be getting mixed up in this.
Save it, Peron. Colonel Eisenberg told us all about what you're up to. Collaborating with a faction of snow pirates
to sabotage our mission and
steal the T-Energy for yourself.
You believe that?
Don't try to deny it. We already found your friends. Their encampment is
under siege as we speak.
The cruiser. It's headed for our home.
It's all right, Mira. Go.
For what it's worth, this upload is working, I think. But without Mira, how do we blow things up?
Maybe looking at a change in priorities.
Roche, I have no beef with you. We don't have to do this. I've seen you with my own eyes. Your secret meetings in the wilderness with them.
Braddock may not see you for what you are, but I do. Who do you think called Nevek down here, huh?
Son of a bitch.
Enough!
After I cut your rig to scrap.
Remember, you brought this on yourself.
Come on, Peron. Don't make this any harder on yourself.
Open your eyes, LaRoche. They're playing you.
If you have nothing to hide, you'd surrender already.
Gale, where's his main generator?
Okay, on the 286s, it's behind his right clavicle. Go after his right shoulder.
Shock him! Do something! betrayed everyone, Tret. And now the White Fox will avenge them.
Dude, he just called himself the White Fox.
My rig! Salo, what have you done?
barge on, Colonel. I'm not dead yet.
Defying quips? Starting to sink in that you're not the triumphant hero? Surely you realize Nevik will come back for me.
Don't bank on it. I think you're dead.
I think I can figure out the relay once we're done here.
Maybe. Except Mira's blown the whole thing up by now.
You're bluffing. Without the relay, you'd be stuck here yourself.
Yeah. Home, sweet home.
You got me angry. You got some fight in you. So did your scientist friend before I put her down. Let's go.
crawled for what felt like days, losing more blood than a man should. Knew she was dead. I'd killed the giver of life. I didn't know if any of us could survive after that.
Jim? Jim? Honey, what happened?
Most of the remaining energy reserves they used up just healing me. Well, most of me. They were grateful. Said all debts were paid. But they didn't know the truth of what I'd done. Like Soyuichi before me, I dedicated myself to protecting those I'd endangered. And you know all about Gale and Mira. Together, they were unstoppable. They ran with their father's work and built the first harmonizers, mimicking Nushi, purifying base T energy to sustain and extend life. Thanks to them, we survived. But without Nushi around to maintain the climate, the whole planet was vulnerable to terraforming and all the nightmares that came with it. Even our best efforts couldn't keep this world a secret forever. Harmonizer tech was just another prize to fight over. By the time a Crimson Unity landed, it was a war without end. Gale took the fight to them. I tried to keep us secret and safe. But our struggles would go on for generations. A birthright of blood for our children. And our grandchildren.
I'm sorry this is the life you were born to. My fight ends today. May you live to see the end of this. Forgive me.
Please don't.
Jim, are you in here, mon ami?
Roche?
Is he, If anyone's earned peace at last, it's him. Au revoir, my oldest friend. Don't worry, you've taught her well.
All grandfather's stories were now my own. My destiny, my own to shape. What if it could all be over? What if we could turn the tables and take this planet back?